So, let's share our stories. And of course, you can continue your conversation later on during the break with the people you just started talking. So, what's in it for us? What do we have to gain if we focus on what we really want? First of all, we can clarify our goals. We know exactly where we want to go. There is an alignment of thoughts and actions, because then, if our thoughts are clear, they can be turned into strategy and actions. We gain personal energy instead of losing energy through thinking of what may go wrong. Strength, resilience, which is a very needed competence nowadays. Flexibility, also very important. Fulfillment, happiness, if I dare say, and also something important that some days we forget, but it's the ultimate goal, health. From your conversations, what else did you feel that is important? What else can we gain if we focus on what we really want? I would like to hear some opinions, some thoughts. What else did you discuss with your partners? Just speak it out loud. Yes, they're at the end. The microphone is coming.
Family.
Family, of course. It goes well also with happiness or fulfillment. Anything else? Yes. You, with the purple shirt.
She absolutely loves doing that. I think she would be happy to continue being a postdoc, but the academic system doesn't really allow you to be a postdoc all your life.
So what can she gain from focusing on what she wants?
She has to find another thing she wants to do.
Okay. So clarify the goals. Anything else that you feel is important? Yes. Think outside of the box. So innovation, creativity, also very important. Anything else? A hand there. Exploration of the world, expanding also your mind map. Yes?
Productivity.
I didn't hear you, sorry.
Productivity.
Mm-hmm. Productivity. Imagine that very often we start our day by thinking of what might go wrong instead of how we'd like our day to be. For example, I wake up and I say I would like a calm, productive, fruitful day, since you used productivity. So if we agree that we have a lot to gain through such a mindset, why do we choose to focus on the things that might go wrong, or on the darker side of our dreams? So what blocks us? Usually the so-called self-limiting beliefs. Because there are beliefs that we have learned more or less until the age of six, and we carry them on as we go through life. It's too difficult, only a few people succeed, it's romantic to pursue your dreams, there are not enough opportunities for me out there, others have more skills, more resources. So social comparison, a lot. And also, what do all these beliefs have in common? Where do they focus? They focus on what we don't have instead of focusing on what we have. And of course, deep down, there is the most common self-limiting belief, I'm not good enough. And it usually goes with the other side of the coin, that I have to be perfect. Because if our goal is to be perfect, which is something that doesn't exist, we are never going to be good enough, because we strive for something that is not there. So bear in mind that as children, we absorb beliefs, values, filters in our thoughts from our family, from our social environment. And until the age of six, as I was telling you, we have formed a kind of mental map. However, as adults, it is again in our hands, and we can change those beliefs. We can work on them through coaching, through therapy, through all the self-awareness processes to see what beliefs we want to keep and what beliefs we would like to change. So where do we focus on? Do we focus on results or on excuses, on reasons? Because if we are looking for people to blame, circumstances, processes, there is a great variety out there. We can blame our parents, the situation, the crisis, the government, many different parameters. But where does this lead us? We want to focus on results. So we want to focus on what we can do to change our lives for the better. And this is when we have to choose between the two different sides. Do we want to be on the cause side or on the effect side? Effect side goes very well with blaming others or putting our fate, our future, our lives into the hands of others. Cause, on the other hand, means that we say, I am responsible for my own life. I can make things happen. Let's see what I can do. I will try my best. I will do the best I can, and also hope that things come through my actions and my energy towards the results I will want. So responsibility and freedom are together on the cause side. And through the coaching sessions, I very often see that people avoid responsibility. Deep down, we would all like to have like a magic wand that just transforms everything without making any effort. But this is not the way that it works. We were never promised that our lives are going to be easy. They're going to be exciting with many ups and downs, but not easy. So freedom and responsibility go well together. And this is something that we also got from the stories that we heard yesterday and today. People did things. They dared things. They said no. They said yes. They explored. So they assumed the responsibility for their own lives, and then they felt the freedom to choose and create their future. This is a famous quote that I really like. I don't know if you're familiar with it, that whether you think you can or you think you can't, you're right in both cases. Can you understand why? It has to do with the so-called self-fulfilling prophecy. If I keep saying inside my head that I won't make it, I won't make it, I won't make it, the thoughts, of course, affect the feelings, the body, the actions. So I create my own reality, not in some metaphysical way, but in a very handy, so to say, way, because I'm not motivated enough to pursue my goals and my dreams. So you have to choose very carefully what you're thinking. Perhaps you have heard the term body-mind. Body and mind are interconnected, they are interrelated. And we see that through science, through humanity, through many different ways. So choose your thoughts very carefully because they create your reality every moment, every day. So, the power of visualization. If we don't see it up here, how are we going to see it out there? It has to do again with clarifying our goals, and then we can have the alignment of goals and actions. There is a very natural mechanism that we have inside of us, which is called active imagination. If I tell you, don't think of a pink elephant, immediately you get a picture in your mind. Maybe a pink elephant or something else, but immediately to that auditory stimulus, you got a response in your head. And active imagination is something that we may forget sometimes as adults, but it's always there. Children are very creative with that. So I would like to ask you to trust me and allow yourselves to relax and close your eyes. You can sit comfortably in your chairs. They're there to support you. You can close your eyes now or in a few seconds. And just listen to my voice and keep your eyes closed until I tell you differently. So, how would you really like to be in 2 years from now? Trust any image that came to your mind, the very first image that you got. How would you like to live? With whom would you like to be? In which country? What would you enjoy doing in 2 years from now? and pay specific attention with all your senses. Hear what you hear in that picture. See what you see. Think what you think. And feel what you feel. So allow yourself and your unconscious mind to really explore what's in there for you and enjoy the pictures that come to your mind, because they're there for a reason. You can make the colors in that picture brighter if this makes the picture more compelling to you. You can make the picture larger or adapt it to any size you want in order to enjoy it more. You can add sounds. You can do it. You can do anything you want with that picture. And observe the feelings that are there. Happiness, calmness, excitement perhaps. Any feeling is allowed because it is your feeling in the picture. And when you are ready, you can gradually keep the picture inside of you, come slowly back to the room, and open your eyes whenever you are ready. If you want to move your hands or anything, or stand up for a while, of course you are free to do so. So I see most of us are back into the room. This is something that you can do. You saw it only takes a few minutes, or even seconds sometimes, if you're used to it. But it's something that really keeps you focused and centered on what you want. You may show something completely different from what you're doing right now. Trust it, explore it, put it to the test. You may show something that provides an answer to dilemmas that you're having right now. Trust it again. Our unconscious mind works 24/7, it's always there. And it keeps the symbols and the meanings that sometimes we don't allow our conscious mind to realize. So, start exploring both resources in order to gain the benefits from both. So just to close, and I'm here to ask any questions, wonder what would change if even today, right now, from this moment on, you started really consciously at the beginning, because it takes practice, to focus on what you really want. And I would suggest a simple exercise from tomorrow morning. Before you get up from bed, say to yourself how you would like your day to be. Not what you're afraid of, not what you don't want. Set up your day to succeed. Thank you very much, and I'm here to answer any questions.